Today we are going to learn about the message-driven program using NetBeans editor. So this program needs we need to have some server-side configuration setup. We need to create the source pooling of the object and destination pooling of the object. We are going to use the GlassFish server to demonstrate this. So the program is an EJB application that demonstrate MDB with appropriate logic. The program is program 12. An EJB application that demonstrate message-driven bean. MDB stands for message-driven bean with appropriate business logic. Step one. So open NetBeans switch to server services explorer window. Then select server, select right click on GlassFish server, right click on GlassFish server. If the server is not yet started, you start the server. If already the server is started, you can skip this start step, and you can again right click GlassFish server. So select the option view admin console. First, let us do this step one, and we will go with the step two. Okay. Now, so before start going to Services Explorer, we need to have a project, enterprise application project we need to create. So right click, new project, Java EE categories, under that projects enterprise application. Click on next. So provide the appropriate name, message driven pro bean program, MDB program, message driven bean program. Next. So by default it is selected GlassFish server. Client EJB module you are going to create, as well as the web application module. Click on finish. So it is going to create the project, enterprise project MDB program, along with two more modules, MDB program EJB module and MDB program var web archive module. So now according to that, step one, switch to the Services Explorer. Select the servers. Try to expand the GlassFish server. So server not yet started. That's why right click on the GlassFish server. Click on start. Click on start. Wait to start the GlassFish. Then, after starting the server, view admin console. Then select JMS resources from the menu list of the Glassfish server. Step 3. Select connection folder. Select connection. First, let us start after starting the Glassfish server. It is now still, it is loading. Once it is up, the server is up, right click on the Glassfish server go on, click on View Admin Console, select that option, View Admin Console. A console is going to load it in your browser. Console is going to load it in your Chrome browser. Which browser you are setting, that browser it opens. Glassfish administration control console. Okay, once the server is loaded onto the browser, from the available list of the options, menu list, among which under the resource folder, there is a subcategory of resource called as JMS resource. Select that JMS resources. JMS resources which has connection factories and destination. JMS resource which has connection factory and destination. Step 4. Select connection factories folder. Step 3, select connection factories folder and create an instance of it by clicking on new. So connection factories, click on connection factories. So already have created one instance, so I'm going to create one more instance for the illustration point of view. Click on new. So create the pool name JMS messages slash JMS slash messages. So select the resource type. Is JMS Queue Connection Factory, and so remaining default, let it be as it is. Then click on OK. It is going to create the source connection factory as JMS messages. Now click on destination resources. Next up is step 4. Click on or select destination destination, resources, create an instance of it by clicking on new, and provide the and click on destination resources, click on new, provide the JNDI name, Java naming directory interface name, provide the JNDI name, for example JMS destinations, the physical name destination resource type, select the JMS queue, click on OK. So you have created JMS destination. Okay. JMS destination. Here JNDI name, physical destination name, and resource type you need to provide. JNDI name, physical destination name, and resource type. This is step 4. After creating these resources, source and destination, now switch back to your NetBean window. Switch back to your NetBean window. Back to the Project Explorer. Now step 5, create message driven bean class file under MDB program - EJB module. So right click on MDB program EJB module, new message driven bean, provide the appropriate name. EJB name is handling message driven bean MDB, handling MDB. So provide the appropriate package PKG. Then select server destination. So JMS destinations. There was two instances exist with the server, previous created destination and just now we have created for our project. Select the server destination which just now we created for our project. That is JMS/destinations. Then click on finish. Click on finish. Now you have created the class handling MDB which implements the message listener interface. Now override this on message message method by adding the override annotation. Now some business logic I'm adding here. I'm going to display the content which is sent from source. This is the destination, this is the MDB file which is handling to showcase the source information to the destination with the help of queue connection factory. So here I'm going to use the system dot out dot println. This is the message parameter you are passing. Message parameter. Which message get string property from, for example, MSG message one. Here, so my string append some string. My message is message. My message for you is. There is a possibility of exception because it is linked with the servlet code. So there is a possibility of JMS exception. If there is no message sending by the servlet, obviously there is a message exception. So you need to handle by surrounding the statement with surround with try catch block. So add one more message, system dot out dot println. Message dot get string property of health message. Okay, so these two messages you are pushing onto the message window of the server with the help of connection factories, which you are going to define now. Now, the next step after creating message driven class file under EJB module, then add business logic to the on message method. Just now we added this business logic. Next, step 6. Now create a servlet by right clicking on MDB program WAR web archive module. So right click on MDB program var new servlet. So I am calling this servlet as sending message servlet. Click on next. Add a deployment descriptor. If you miss this step, that this your class is not going to register with the web container, then it is unable to identify it. So that's why you need to check this checkbox. Then click on finish. It is going to create the server name as sending message servlet. Now within the try final block, I removed that commented text. Now,
sir, repeat previous step, sir.
Yeah, which one?
This last step, sir. You created
a deployment descriptor.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I am going to create one more servlet to illustrate repeatedly. Otherwise, I will delete this servlet. Again, I am going to recreate the same servlet. So under the MDB program where, click on new servlet. So provide the name of the servlet as sending message servlet. Click on next. This step is very important. Add deployment information to deployment descriptor. If you miss this step, just if you click on finish without clicking on this checkbox, your server exists with the container but not registered. So to register that with the web container, so you need to click on this add information to deployment descriptor checkbox. So when you click, class name is going to be added as a part of that web.xml servlet name and URL pattern which it is going to locate while executing your application. Click on finish. Once if you click on finish, NetBeans provides the template text for you. So within that, I am going to remove the commented content from this try finally block of servlet. Here I am going to insert the code which supports for sending a message to the message bin. Now right click, insert code. You will have so many options here. In that, select send JMS message. Very, very, very important step. You remember this step. Server destination, selected destinations. Okay. Connection factory, what the name we were given there? JMS/destinations. There is no factory. What is the connection factory source name we given? What is the source name of the JMS?
JMS
messages, right? Connection factory name we have given JMS messages, whereas server destination is JMS destination. This is very important step. Most of us, we are forgetting this step to modify the content of this connection factory, because something you are creating there, something you are adding here, means there is mismatch in the instance, your application won't run. Okay, this is the important step in this MDB, especially that remove that factory string from this JMS messages. Click on OK. So the NetBeans provides the code for it. See, it is added the annotations. Resource name, destination is JMS destinations. The connection factory is JMS messages. Now the corresponding method which you are defining here is send JMS message to destinations. Send JMS message to destinations. So I am deleting this particular object message data parameter, and I am calling this method in the try finally block. I am calling this method in the try finally block. Try finally block, then out.println, a message to the client is that see the output of this program in Glassfish log window. So there is a possibility of exception, so surround the statements with try catch block. Okay, then now I am modifying the code. I am modifying the code. I'm modifying code. I'm going to create the message which you are pushing onto the server machine. So a message MSG one equal to session dot create message. So MSG one dot set string property. The first name is key value. That is the key value. What you have given in the key? What is the name you given here? MSG one, right? MSG one. MSG one, and the value is. All the best for exams. All the best for exams. Then another message we have created. Another message we have created. MSG one dot set string property. What is the message name we given here? Health message. Health message. Provide the information. Stay home. And be healthy. Now you are sending this message what you have created using message producer. Here you are creating a connection for the messages belongs to the connection factory. Messages belongs to the connection factory. You created the connection for that, and you created the session for that to push on to the connection, create session. Then message producer class produces the message, pushes that message by using that current session with the help of the create producer method, where destination is the destination of the server, that is Q type of the destination. It will pushes the message onto the server window. Then you are going to create the message by using the message class, which invoke on the current session by calling the create message. You are created the instance of message, and you can have a hundreds of messages here. You can push whatever you are going to push is with the help of message producer dot send. Send is invoked MSG one. MSG one here two set of messages is present in MSG one. It is pushing on to when message producer dot send message, it is pushing onto the on message. It will call the on message window. Okay, then now the code is ready to run the application. The next step is right click on MDB program where go to the properties, set the relative path of the program execution. Right click on the MDB program where, go to the properties, select the run method. here in the rear relative URL box, put slash and paste it here. Paste the name of the server. What is the name of the servlet? The name of the servlet which you defined is sending message servlet. The name of the servlet which you defined is sending message servlet. So right click on var file, properties, run, relative URL slash, paste it. Sending message servlet slash sending message servlet. Now the relative URL is set for execution of your program. Click on OK. Now right click on var file, run the program. So you will get the output in the browser window. So what message you are getting the output in the browser window? See the output of this program in Glassfish log window. So this message is for you, for your understanding sake, this message has given. Where you get the message? In the Glassfish log window. Now switch to the Glassfish. Switch to the Glassfish log window. So come back to the NetBean editor. Move your cursor to the output window. Select the Glassfish server. See last two lines of this Glassfish server. This is the output of your program. Information, my message for you is all the best for exams. Stay safe, stay home and be healthy. Is the output of your program. Is it clear where you get the output? You get the output under the Glassfish log window. That's all about the program.